Hi! I'm back, finally. It's been a while since I recorded the last one of these. You know, I got a new mic. My last one broke. Hopefully you can hear that. I think this one's better. But so that was why I stopped recording for a while, and then just some other stuff came up, but I won't go too into detail about it. The important thing is I'm back, and we have, like, three different people to talk to. So let's go talk to some dudes. An exciting return, an exciting adventure back into this. So this is a chef. I think we rescued him at some point. My knowledge is a little foggy. I know the last thing we did was we, like, secured that town that was full of undead. But anyway, let's talk. Well, if it isn't my savior, I cannot thank you enough. I finally get to cook for other people again. Here! Have some soup. Could use some salt, but Captain Wishke over there insists that it's for combat use only. Salt? I guess that's like a wound cleansing thing, but glad you've settled in, mate. I did a thumbs up there, but you can't see that because I don't have a face cam or anything. Yay, I got some reputation. The ironclad chef. Woo. I'll take some more soup. I don't know what that did, but I got some soup. Later, old man. Oh, we're so hip. We're such a cool guy. This is the blacksmith, the one that we chose. I think the weaponsmith. Hopefully it's the weaponsmith, because I want some weapons. Let's go. Alright, don't know why I walked over there, but, not a bad place you got here. Many souls in need of my services. Seems I'll be plenty busy. By the way, I don't even come close to remembering any voices I did, so if you liked one in particular, hopefully I'll like it again, but do not expect that. Glad you decided to join us, mate. 800 XP, woo! Ooh, whoa. The blacksmith allows you to craft powerful items using the blueprints you've learned and various crafting components. Okay. That's fun. What the fuck does any of this mean? Oh, that's cool. One physical damage? Okay. So green is good, right? Green appears to be good. I haven't been playing as many ARPGs lately either. Like, I got way back into World of Warcraft, and as many of you would guess, that is a bit of a time consumer, but I played some Diablo 3 because I hadn't played that in a while. That was a good time. I'm just still trying to look at this. I guess we want a bladed mace. That seems okay. Better than this axe that deals one damage? I'm assuming it's like level scaling, and I guess this one isn't. See, it's like, I would definitely make the blue one, but it's a mace. I don't want a mace. And I only have, like, one of these, so that seems pretty important, but... Oh, we can make specific implements that, like, go on our weapons. That's, like, really good, actually, because I remember we want cold. Oh, or not... It's a dagger? Hold, I think I really want to make this one. I'm gonna... How much? I have a lot of iron. What the fuck is... Okay. Apparently implement means wand. I was hoping it was like a component, you know, like this, basically. I wanted more of these because I know cold is really good with that passive that we have. I remember that much. So apparently this is just fucking wands, but... We got, like, a green one at least. That's cool. A sword? I could go for a sword. I don't know. I think we're... That's enough of that for now. It's main story time. We gotta talk to Mr. Captain over here.
Have you found a rift gate in Burwich? What's the situation out there?
I mean, it's swarming with ethereal corruption, but the rift gate's secure. So, we got that going for us. That's nice.
Good work. While you were gone, I dug through some of the files in this office, and I think we have our target. As you are acutely aware, Ethereals can possess humans and bend them to their will. I always had my suspicions, but now I have little doubt.
The
former warden of this prison is possessed. Well before the Grim Dawn, in fact.
Oh, shit. How can you be sure? That was close.
There have been countless holes in the prison records. Prisoners just disappearing, never to be seen again. The warden's personal logs paint a more complete picture. He's been transferring prisoners into a secret facility underneath his mansion in Burwich Village for years. What for, I don't know, but I'm sure it wasn't for rehabilitation. There are also several mentions of ethereals and riftgates. I need you to find this man, or whatever he has become.
Aye, sounds good. Where can I find this man?
Warden Krieg owned a mansion in the northern district of Burwich Village. The logs indicate that his facilities can be reached via the cellar. I'm afraid I don't have more to go on, but if we want to strike back at the ethereal power structure in the region, the warden is our prime target.
Got it. Dude's fucking dead. Mark my words. All right. I don't know what that said, but I don't think I care. Let's make sure there's not any new quests or anything up here, because there fucking is. Ha! Sorry if I insulted you earlier. Your origins were just a bit startling. I can understand that, yeah. I hear that that you brave the dangers beyond Lower Crossing. Braved, honey. Braved. We're fucking done with that shit. I was wondering if you could help gather some materials. Oh, fuck. Did I, like, not get this one forever ago? Because that would suck. What do you need? You see, I was a seamstress before the Grim Dawn. Is this, like, new? This is the first time I remember seeing refer to the Grim Dawn as an event, but whatever. Nothing special, just made enough to get by. But now I see an opportunity to use my trade to make a difference around here. I would like to sew some new canopies and maybe some new clothes if there is enough fabric left. Alex and Jane deserve better than this. Yeah, sure. If you could please gather any fabric you find, the people here would be grateful. The waterfront in Burwich would be a good place to start looking. Got you. On it. Collect fabric. Okay, so I guess I'm pretty sure that just sounds like we're just gonna get some stuff, like the scrap quest earlier in the story. Which is cool. That's fine. And hopefully that's it, and we can go kill some stuff. Because I would enjoy that. Although, I want to go look up here real quick, because I remember at like the beginning of the game, there's like a bridge you can repair up here. And I want to see if I can do that. 6 scrap and 300 iron, bitch. Bitch. Yeah, totally. I'm pretty sure I have that. 6 scrap is kind of a lot, but fuck it, let's do it. That was louder than I was expecting. Okay. Let's... Where am I? I don't want to, like, fuck it, we're going. No, we're going. I need to see what's over here. Dead horse. Ow! Oh, he's a tough boy. Oh, he's a sadist. That's cool. These gentlemen hurt quite a bit. Like, not that bad, but, you know, it's something. Yeah, they appear to be higher level than me. I don't think I'm supposed to be over here yet. So, after I kill these guys, we're going back. Okay, I'm in dude heaven right now. Just being shot by guys. And other things. Okay, there we go. Just pick up the stuff that isn't common, and I will just be leaving you gentlemen in peace. Good day. Let's go do the actual storyline we're supposed to be doing. There's a fucking star on the map. Okay, that's just giving the fabric to her. I don't know why that was on the map for 2 seconds. Whatever, we're going to Burwich. Look at how far we gone. Look at how far. I really hope the mouse is showing up on the screen this time. I'm recording it a slightly different way that in my tests I thought looked better. I guess we will see if that is in fact the case. Silver amulet. Want. Probably doesn't do anything, but I want it. Little bit of lag there. I don't know why this game just lags sometimes. It's kind of annoying. Okay, okay. In my my Diablo 3 escapades I briefly spoke of earlier, I was mostly playing Barbarian, which was easy as all godly fuck, so I might have to do a little bit of adjustment here. Going back to potentially a slightly harder game. Just mostly remembering to heal. Because I have one that seems fairly good. What is... Okay. Okay. Where are we going now? This way, I guess. I choose this way. Ow, he exploded, I think. Okay, a lot of dudes that hurt, a lot of hurty dudes. Nothing I can't handle, me, Mr. Strong, dashing rogue man. This game's pretty good. I remember why I wanted to record this game now. It's pretty good. It's nothing really deeper than that, it's just pretty good. Oh, there's a dude heaven right there. Where's dude heaven even from? I'm pretty sure it's a stir thing, but whatever. I want to get in dude heaven. Am I hurting them? We are attacking each other through the walls. I really don't know if there's a hole here or if I'm just attacking them through this window. I think I'm attacking them through the window. Well, I guess it makes that part easier at least. Okay, I hit a door and it breaks shit across the room. That's fun. Scrap. Is this a weapon? It is a weapon. Okay, fun fact, you can kill people through walls. That's a good time. A fun little happenstance. Woo! Dusty Lect cultist orders. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Oh. That gave me a quest. Hold on, then. I feel as if I should read this. It's not even a lore thing. It is purely a quest item. Whatever.
Brothers of the Blood. The ethereal presence in Berwitch grows stronger with each passing day. We are shifting our operations beyond the city limits, where we may proceed with our plans undisturbed. Our focus now turns upon Devil's Crossing, where our newest agent, Dorini, has successfully sabotaged their water pump. Soon that irksome group will be forced to flee their sanctuary, and then they shall be at our mercy, mwahahahahahahahaha. Ready yourselves, brothers. Soon we shall drink of their blood. Salazar, Blade of Cthon.
Well, shit, that's some fucking intrigue going on right there. Guess we'll go back to that later. Right now, we got some adventuring to do and some straight-up zombies to kill. Everything is misty because of this thing I have on, and I gotta admit that is kind of throwing me off. Like, it's the entire screen just kind of looks foggy. Okay, that's not. That was already over there. Looks like there's something over here to do. Stairs down? Okay. Is there nothing in this house? Nothing in the house. Okay. Cool, great. Just a little cemetery filled with dudes. I guess it's like the side entrance from Mudrow, actually. That would make sense. But we are not interested in that right now. What we are interested in is adventures. Fucking explodey dudes. I am not using my... Okay. Serious explodey dudes going on. Oh no, dog. So much is exploding. So many explodey dudes. My gold health meter is, I think, the lowest it's ever been. So that's fun. That has something to do with fast regeneration, I have finally learned, which I always kind of figured, but I'm more sure... Man! I'm more sure of it now than I was, which is why we're going to heal ourselves there to keep it from going down more, even though we're, like, not in combat. Journeyman's Peck. Nice. There we go. And then... Never mind. Got some food. All good. Okay, I can't go that way. I can go this way. Alright, this is a new way. This is good. Is that a crystal? That's a crystal. Not anymore. Ho-ho, got him. Okay. Wasn't sure if I could go in there or not. Turns out I could. That gold health goes down really fast. Like, I was gonna heal myself there, because I didn't figure... Okay, dogs. Okay, dogs. Ooh, dogs. Or fireman. One of the two. One of you two hurt. Okay, level 18. Wasn't sure what level I was. Good to know. Give me a scrap. Let me fight a man. Let me fight a man. I leveled up. That's what I need to do. Okay, not... Don't walk that far. Fuck. Okay. Throw one in this, because that's good. This one is pretty good. I guess... Throw knives? I think I want to throw knives better. Does it lower the cooldown or anything? No. That would be nice. That one's pretty good. This one's pretty good. Does this one lower the cooldown? No. That one doesn't lower the cooldown, because that one doesn't have a cooldown. Silly. That. Brat. So where are we going now? Stairs? I didn't see stairs. Let's go to the stairs. I really don't remember stairs at all. There are stairs here? Oh, there's a cellar. Oh. Wasn't something in the cellar? I remember something being in the cellar. Zombies, but that's pretty much a given at this point. I don't think that's what it was. It's a beholder. Woohoo! Beholding man. I want to be over there. There's a star man waiting in the sky. He wants to come and meet us, but he thinks he'd blow our minds. What? When did I use my... Oh, that is a tanky fucking dude. Whoo, that is a really tanky dude. He survived a teleport. Okay, I'm gonna run. Just going to kite like I feel I am quite proficient at on this character. I do not hurt Mr. Starman. Even that, like my hardest hitting ability, does not hit him very hard. And he blocks my knives like an inconsiderate dickhole. Alright, probably like a couple more of those. Okay. There we go. Got him. Some stuff that I will look at later. Yeah, that's fucking right. That's right, you give me shit. Not like, you know, sass, not sass shit. You give me like gear shit. Rotting corpse. A very wealthy rotting corpse. Okay. Aw. No lore. No lore for us today. Sad. I have a lot of health potions. I have 60 health potions. That's a lot of health potions. Am I missing anything back here? It doesn't look like it. Nothing big, at least. Ratmen! And porcupine-y type dude. And die. Okay. Vital essence, I guess, is a healing thing. Human remains. Those are definitely healing things if you know how to use them, if you know what I mean. Ho 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 ho. You know, that was one of those, like, jokes. It's not supposed to be that funny. But, you know, fuck it. That was funny. I'm a funny man. I'm pretty good, you know? You know, the whole, like, comedy thing? Yeah, I'm pretty good at that. Babbity-bab. You know what else I'm good at? Killing dudes. Think I've proved that fairly well. Like, rats? Bro, they don't even touch me. Sellers? Done. Dudes with stars over their heads, those can, in fact, touch me. That is not impervious to that. Alright, where am I now? Nowhere. Actually, I think I do care about that. I was going to say nowhere I care about, but I don't know. I'm not sure if I care about this. I have a lot of attack speed. I like that. I like attack speed in a man. That's a lot of dudes. I do not have that much AoE. That is a thing I am lacking sorely. I have like one AoE skill and it's, I think, pretty good, honestly, but I only have like one AoE skill. Other than that, I am all auto attacks. Barrel. Alright, well, I guess let's go this way as long as I can, because this looks like a new type area. Woo! There's some AoE for ya. I forgot I had that like random proc extra AoE too. That can definitely help out in a pinch. Fuck you. But I killed your crystal. That means you're not supposed to spawn. That's how it works, I thought. Apparently not according to these zombies. Whatever. Is my inventory like close to full? Kinda is the answer. Can I break these? Oh, I can. Take that, whoever was buried there. I have destroyed your legacy. The only thing you left in this world. A fucking gravestone. You worthless piece of shit. Doors? Yo, doors don't even stand up against me, okay? They just gone. Yeah, apparently those stairs were, like, worthless, and that was not the cellar I was thinking of, because I am just over here now. And there's obviously some stuff over there, and you know what? I'm gonna go to it, because bridge feels like the way to go, and you never want to go the way you're supposed to go. You gotta do all the exploring. You gotta get out there and see the world and such. Why does it feel like my attack speed got way lower? What have you done to me, you monsters? And it's another bridge that feels like it could be the way to go, and we're closer to this one, so we're going that way after we kill some zombies. That didn't kill him. Or it did. I guess he just decided to explode, and I just realized I was taking damage. Excuse me. Got a little tickle going on. I see some stairs over here. Abandoned waterfront. This is where we were, like, looking for cloth, yeah? Okay. Eyeballs hurt. Hurty eyeballs. Reputation updated. Despised with ethereals. Guys, we did it. People hate us. Yay! We're so good, adventure men. Cloth, perhaps? Yep. Fabric number one. Fabric obtained. You know, they say the first sign of a good adventurer is that people all around the world hate you. And we... God damn, there are a lot of eyeballs here. Holy shit. So much electricity. He's gonna explode. I realized it too late. What a fool I am. Okay, potion time. Potion time. Why do I still have a heartbeat? I still had a heartbeat after I was fine for like 10 seconds. Die. Please. Please die. Please. You too. Hold on, I'm just gonna like... Ah. Apparently it even heals me in combat. I was trying to like wait out some heals there to... To, you know, abuse my golden health, but then I got it all refilled anyway, so... Apparently I'm too good for this game, I guess. Alright, whatever. We got fabric to get. Let's get some fabric. Some end of the dock fabric, I can appreciate that. Was I, like, not even picking up yellows? I feel like that's potential, because I've gotten a lot of yellows, it feels like. But anyway, we need some cloth. Hey, dude. He exploded. Bit of a delayed explosion, you know? Whip. Alright. And our final fabric. And that is where I'm going to end this episode. So... Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.